So with Bacon, we have this passing on of the lamp. The idea that there has been, since the beginning of time, in this world, groups of people who have known the facts. Various terms have been given to them. Muhammad recalled these folk people when he spoke of the primordial sages of the world. In various religions, they appear. They represent mysterious, powerful factors that have dominated life. In most cases, these original sages, if we might call them that, have had very quiet lives and sometimes have been bitterly persecuted. The better these people have become, the more they have taught, the more they have sacrificed, the more they have been ridiculed and persecuted. But the fact remains that no amount of ridicule can change a fact, nor make an untruth true. So back in those times where Bacon is talking about the sons of wisdom, there were these sacred mysteries, these schools, these esoteric bodies that existed to perpetuate the inner truths of life. Now, many people are unhappy because these organizations had a tendency to be what we have termed as exclusive. We feel that, many people at least feel, that these organizations have gone on nurturing a few favored persons and allowed the world as itself to go along as it was. That these institutions have not opened themselves to the common needs of the common people. It was the idea that these should be parental organizations that simply descended and took care of the needs of everybody. But such was not possible, and such was not the intent. It was what was hoped would prove to be a permanent motion in society toward which those who were concerned with a better way of life could progress gradually to the understanding of basic principles. If wisdom is bestowed upon those morally unfit, it will become a very serious form of black magic. It becomes a terror and a danger. The more skillful we become, the more dangerous we become, unless we control skill with wisdom, love, and truth. No skill is safe unless the person possessing it is morally integrated. No skill can go along continually serving mankind usefully unless those possessing that skill do not abuse it, do not misuse it, and do not sacrifice the common good for personal profit or advantage. So a profit system has come in by means of which the wisdom of the ages has been tempered down to the point where individuals can benefit materially from rules, principles, and laws that they are supposed to apply to the inner daily life of their conscience and their integrities. And at the moment, many groups and individuals all over the world are reaching out to find the formula for this justice, to find out what it is that can bring the individual out of the dilemma and at the same time give him the incentives to a better way of life. This thought is also carried on by Bacon when he turns from the lamp to the New Atlantis. The New Atlantis is a symbol of a commonwealth based much upon Moore, André, and many others, but a symbol of a world properly governed, a world in which there will always be room for everyone, where overpopulation will not exist, where crime will be reduced to a minimum, and where an individual will be honored for his integrities rather than his possessions. Also, we find constant temptations, most of them arising from the profit concept. Nearly every major fault we have today has been exaggerated because it was financially advantageous to somebody. And gradually, finances have taken over. And I remember the fable that finds in Stanley's History of Philosophy, where someone was talking with a philosopher, and he said, why is it that great wealthy people feed the hungry and the poor and the sick, but never do anything to help the wise? And Plato replied, it's very simple. They're all afraid they may be sick and hungry someday themselves, but they are not afraid that they will be wise. And this is more or less the problem that we have.